The name of this game is Gate, and turn up your sound, because now is a time that to make plenty of noise, and you can talk, and you can listen to the sound, and just play the game and see how it goes. What do we do when we're stuck? Yes, Jacob.
Ask a partner,
okay. What else can we do if we're stuck?
One of the similarities between math and gameplay is the value of perseverance. Kids need to learn that struggling is okay. It's okay if they don't get it right away. A kid playing a game will persevere and keep trying to figure it out. They don't need somebody standing there telling them what to do every minute. And we're looking for the same thing in math. We're looking for kids to develop strategies for what to do when they don't know what to do.
You don't just wait for somebody to come and rescue you. It means you try stuff. And you'll get unstuck. And if you don't get unstuck after a while, then we'll work together and we'll find a way to get unstuck. But it's about you thinking about the game, not about me showing you how to play the game.
One of the most important things about teaching this kind of a lesson is watching what the kids are doing as they play the games.
I don't know how to make that.
Oh, okay. What did you try?
What issues do they run into? What questions do they have? Where do they get stuck? What are the interactions between kids?
What's the plus one for?
I'm not sure, I haven't used it yet.
I walk around and I take notes on what they're doing. And this is really important because at the end of the gameplay, I want to have a discussion with them and I want the discussion to come from them. It's much more powerful if it comes from their own struggles and their own experiences with the game.
Mute your game and pause it, please. For a minute, I want to talk about a few things that have come up. The first thing I want to talk about this number 34.2. So I actually saw several of you make this number, but you didn't make it the same way.
One of the main points of Gate is to learn to think flexibly about numbers, to realize that numbers can be built in many different ways, that in fact any given number can be built in an infinite number of ways.
Moy, do you remember making 34.2? Do you remember what order you made it in?
I hit W 4 times, and then I hit D.
Okay. So you hit 4 W's, and then 6 D's.
I hit R twice.
And R twice. Are there more ways to get 34.2 than what these guys did? Mm-hmm. Who else got a third, remembers making 34.2? Jacob? So what are we learning in this game? Kaya, where's the math?
Well, we're learning place value.
Okay. Can you tell me what that means?
Place value is like where the numbers are put.
Okay. So can you give me an example using this 334.2 about what you just said about place value? The next thing I want to come to, let's talk a little bit about fingers. I've noticed that you put your fingers on the keyboard a little bit differently.
The game's a lot easier to play if you put your hands on the keyboard in the home position like you're typing. And usually there's a couple kids who figure that out on their own, and then you can ask that kid to show the others how they do it, and then a lot of the other kids will pick up on it as well.
Any questions about that? How other ways that you guys use the keys?
Kids are going to find a lot of strategies for playing the game, and they're going to want to share them with each other, and that's great because those strategies for playing the game almost always lead to strategies about the math. And then you tell them, okay, now you're going to play it again, and I want you to think about the math we've been talking about and how it helps you play the game.
I need everybody's attention up here for just a minute while I show you a couple of things that might help you when you're doing this for homework. So first of all, there is a screen called Tips. So look on your screen and see if you can locate this. And it's right here on mine. You know, sometimes you just don't know what to do. You can always go to the tip screen and see if there's something there that might help you. Now, one of the tips is use the practice level off the main menu. Now, when you're in practice mode, you can't die. You can play the game and make numbers and you won't win, but you also won't lose. So it's a way to sort of make the numbers slowly and gradually without having the pressure of being chomped. Yeah, exactly. So one more thing I need to show you. What I want you to do is go to this screen, the level selector screen, then just type capital C, shift C. Try that and see what happens.
With games, one of the most important things a teacher does is help the students reflect on what they've done in the game.
When you played this game, what were you doing that was math? Jacob.
Multiplying decimal numbers.
When you make the numbers, You have to like know what plus what equals what.
Okay.
on those little floating rocks that have like the plus one.
Yeah. Tell me a little more about those.
You need to like learn how to multiply and to add so you can make the numbers faster.
Okay, so what I heard you guys saying is that you were, in this game, you were building numbers in different ways and practicing different operations like addition and multiplication and subtraction. So, Kaya, would you hand a few of those, like give maybe three to each?
Hands-on learning is so important. We do a lot of math with paper and pencil, but that's not enough to develop deep conceptual understanding. When a student is engaged in a hands-on activity and they have control over what they're doing, the concepts become much more meaningful to them.
We're going to make some numbers. Remember, we've been making numbers with this game. We're going to make numbers with paper. This is going to be one. It doesn't matter what color they are. All of them, they're all different colors, but that's just how long they are. This is one. Can you make two? He's got one next to one. This is what I want you to think about. I want you to think about a number as one, two. How about five? You can cut them, but let's not cut yet because these are still whole numbers. Okay, these guys have got five. Yeah, we're thinking about number line and length. We're thinking about something that's five long. Okay? All right, now how about, can you make 2.5? Now you can use the scissors. All right, 2.5. I see everybody's got 2.5. 2.1.
Math isn't just about following a process. It's about understanding why the process works.
Kaya, can you tell me what you're doing with your piece of paper there?
So we were trying to make tents because the one was in the tenth place, and then we would cut off one of them, and then that would be one tenth.
3.14.
Another important takeaway from GATE is an understanding of the relative scale of the different decimal places. Even if a kid knows the names of the different places, like the tenth place and the hundredth place, that doesn't mean they necessarily understand the sizes of the quantities involved. An activity like this really brings home the sizes of the different decimal places.
This is kind of a tricky thing. This doesn't mean 14 tenths. What place is this for in? Yes.
The hundredth.
The hundredth place. Does anybody have a hundredth? Did anybody make a hundredth? I want you to come look at these hundredths that these guys made. And yeah, they're really small, right? You got to get up really close. That's why I want you to come stand over here, because the hundredths are kind of small. Convince us that this is a hundredth. What we just did with the paper, making different numbers with these strips of paper. Where do you see something like that in the game?
If you put GATE up in practice mode so you don't die, you can have a great classroom discussion about multiple representations of numbers.
Tell me one math idea that came out of this game.
Decimals,
all right.
Place value.
Tenths.
Addition.
Multiplication.
Rounding.
Tell me about rounding.
Well, if you have a number like 29, you might as well just go to 30.
Okay.
Which would be 3 W's, and then that way you could just subtract one, which is D.
So you're saying that playing this game is kind of like knowing how to round helps you play this game better?
Mm-hmm.
So maybe we ought to talk about that tomorrow. I think rounding would be a good thing for us to work on tomorrow, and I like that idea. We'll start with that. But remember tonight, you can play the game again. Play it as much as you want.
Yay.
But let's go have lunch now.
We know that for deep learning to take place, it is critical that students reflect on what they're learning. This is where the role of the teacher is crucial. You know your students. You know what questions you need to ask them to bring out their mathematical thinking. The game is just a tool to help you do that.